Meenu and Chinu love chocolate.
Children, look here. Look at what I have got for you.
Chocolates? Thank you, Grandma. We love chocolates.
Yummy. I love chocolates.
I have a bone for you too, Raja.
Grandma, I want this chocolate. This rectangular chocolate is for me.
No, Grandma, the square-shaped chocolate is smaller. Chinu always gets the bigger chocolate. This time, I want the rectangular one.
No, Grandma. I asked for it first. The rectangular chocolate is for me.
Grandma, Chinu does this every time.
Oh, my sweet Meenu, don't worry. Relax, both of you. Putta, will you please help me find out which is the bigger chocolate? Then, I will divide the chocolates equally for Meenu and Chinu.
Sure, Grandma. Let me help you.
Grandma, I also want to share.
Oh, Buzz, you will also get your share.
Actually, Grandma, both the chocolates are of the same size. I mean, their area is the same.
Area? What do you mean by area? And how can these two chocolates be of the same size? Grandma, Putta is cheating. He wants Chinu to get the bigger piece.
Why will I cheat? I also like Meenu a lot.
Oh, then Futta doesn't know how to measure.
Buzz, it is not fair to blame Futta. Let us first ask him why he says both the chocolates are of the same size.
Futta, tell us please. The rectangular chocolate looks bigger.
Take a look. Both the chocolates are of different shape, right? But can you see that both chocolates are made of small squares?
Yes, they are.
The small squares are 1 centimeter long and 1 centimeter wide.
Yes, Futta, it is supposed to be like that in a square. Both the sides, the length and the breadth will be of the same size in a square. Let me see. Yes, they are. The squares in both the chocolates are of the same size. The squares are 1 centimeter long and 1 centimeter wide.
Let us call them 1 centimeter squares. Buzz, Now tell me, how many small squares are there lengthwise and how many are there breadthwise in the square-shaped chocolate?
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
There are 4 squares in both the directions.
Okay, Buzz. How many squares does that make in total?
Futta, this is not fair. You could have asked me to do that earlier instead of making me count only the length and breadth. I would have counted all the squares.
Buzz, it is 16 squares. There are 16 small squares in all.
Let me count them.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
There are totally 16. Futta, next time please don't make me do the same things again and again. But Meenu, how did you do it so fast?
Buzz, you have to multiply the number of squares in length and number of squares in breadth to get the answer. Buzz, how much is 4 multiplied by 4?
It is 16.
So, isn't the answer the same?
Yes, it is.
Okay, let us get back to our area. Since there are 16 squares of 1 centimeter each, the area of the square chocolate is 16 square centimeters.
Oh my God! Futta, stop, stop! Meenu, he talks of new words. He never told me what area means. I don't know what square centimeter means.
Buzz, look, this chocolate is in the shape of a square. Whatever surface we have inside the shape is called its area. So, this is the area of this chocolate. Now, we need to know what the area is. There are 16 squares in this area. Each of them is of 1 centimeter. So, the area is 16 square centimeter.
Now I know.
Time to calculate the area of the rectangular chocolate. Buzz, please count the number of squares lengthwise and breadthwise of this rectangular chocolate.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2.
There are 8 squares in length and 2 squares in breadth in the chocolate.
So, How many squares does it make?
I know, the answer is 16 because I multiplied 8 and 2, which is 16.
That's correct. Now, doesn't that make the area 16 square centimeters?
Oh, yes, it does.
That is why I said the areas of both chocolates are the same, even though they don't look the same.
See, I was not cheating. I just wanted to have the rectangular chocolate because I like the shape.
Chinu, you did not know the areas were the same. So, you were asking for the larger looking chocolate.
centimeters.
Oh, Putta, how do you say that?
Let us see the outline.
Putta, how do you calculate the area over the half squares?
Let me explain. The biscuit is occupying 6 squares in length and 2 full squares in breadth. How much area does that make?
That is 12 square centimeters.
Yes. Buzz, now tell me how many half squares are occupied by the biscuit?
It is occupying 6 half squares.
2 halves make 1. So tell us, how much does 6 halves make?
It makes 3. I divided 6 by 2, which is 3.
And how much is 12? Plus 3?
It is 15. So, the area of the biscuit is 15 square centimeters. The area of the chocolates was 16 square centimeters.
Yes, that is why I said the biscuit is smaller in area.
Let us do a small exercise. Putta, can you please tell us the size of each square in the board?
Yes, Grandma. It is 1 square centimeter.
So, who can tell me what is the area of the chessboard?
It is 64 square centimeters. I did 8 into 8, which is 64.
Good. Putta, please draw a diagonal
line
across the board. Now, the square has been divided into 2 triangles. So, children, can you tell me what is the area of each triangle?
Grandma, both the triangles should have an area of 32 square centimeters.
Yes, he is correct.
How can you both say that? You have not even counted the squares.
Buzz, a diagonal line divides a square into 2 equal triangles. So the area will also be equal. It is the same for a rectangle also. If we draw a diagonal line across a rectangle, then it divides the rectangle into 2 equal halves.
The total area of the board was 64 square centimeters, and the diagonal has created 2 triangles whose area would be half of 64. How much is that, Buzz?
It is 32. That is 64 divided by 2, which is 32. So you are correct.
Buzz, can you tell how many triangles of 32 square centimeters we can draw in this square.
We can totally draw 4. We already have 2. If we erase this diagonal line and draw a diagonal line connecting the other 2 corners, we will get 2 more.
Actually, children, you can draw many more triangles of 32 square centimeters. Why don't you try drawing them now? Well done, children.
This way, we can measure the area of any shape and compare the areas of objects of different sizes.
Come on, everybody. Let us compare the sizes of our feet. Mine is 90 square centimeter. Let us also include Raja.
Look, Raja's is only 4 square centimeters. Mine will be very less.
Come on now. Let us do something new. Okay, children, can you complete this into a triangle of 4 square centimeters?
Friends, similarly, we can make many more shapes if we have the area. It doesn't have to be a triangle alone. It can be any pattern.
Grandma, aren't the tiles on our floor also made the same way? I saw Ramu uncle making tile patterns on the floor for a new house one day. He was cutting the tiles and making patterns.
Yes, children, that is how they can fix tiles which are not square or rectangular in shape in a square or rectangular shaped room.
Grandma, why don't we draw some design for the tiles in our room?
Let me also help. Let me find the area of your room so that you will know how many tiles you would require.
This sounds like a lot of fun. Friends, today we have learned how to calculate the area of various shapes. You can also draw a big square pattern like us with the help of your friends and measure the area of different things like books,
Books,
please. Your hands. Why don't you practice this same and design some new tiles for your classroom? You can also play fun games by taking 5 squares or 7 squares, rearranging them and fitting them into 5 into 10 rectangles or 7 into 12 rectangles. Have fun designing!